So this week we're going to cover the topic of genetics. Genetics covers a lot of different areas, but specifically it's going to be the study of genes, inheritance, and variation. And geneticists are going to try and answer a lot of different questions. How do different genes interact? So we know that genes are sections of DNA that code for particular proteins. So if you have two or three different genes all being expressed, what is the result of those proteins interacting? So what is genetic variation? Why is it important, and how do we get it? Why do I look different from my siblings? We came from the same genetic pool, so why don't all of us look the same? Very important area of genetic research is disease, and what is the genetic basis of disease, and how can diseases be carried through generations? So we're going to start off with some basic terminology, and some of these terms we have used in other lectures, but we need to just get all of these words down so that we can use them for the rest of the topic. So a gene is a section of DNA that codes for a particular protein. A chromosome is a tightly coiled piece of DNA. And of course, humans have 46 chromosomes, or 23 pairs, one from mom and one from dad. And this picture just illustrates the relationship of genes and chromosomes. So you have your DNA, little sections of the DNA are individual genes, and when we take that DNA with many genes on it and tightly coil it up, we have a chromosome. And remember, those chromosomes are going to live in the nucleus of every cell in your body. The genome is all of the DNA for a particular species. So there's a mouse genome, there's a fruit fly genome, there's a corn genome, and then of course we have the human genome. The human genome was mapped in 2003, and they estimated from that project that we have about 25,000 genes. It took many researchers and different universities all working together to create the human genome. It took them 13 years. The technology that was developed, however, has made it much faster. And now you can get the genome for a species in about 3 weeks. It's still very expensive, but we have the computers and hardware to make that happen quickly. Genotype and phenotype. The genotype is the genetic code of a specific individual. Now, we just talked about a genome. A genome is the genetic code for an entire species. So you and I share the human genome, but you and I each have our own unique genotype, and that's the genetic code of me as an individual and you as an individual. Your genotype always includes two copies of each gene, and again, you got one from mom and one from dad. The phenotype are the physical and behavioral traits of the organism, so what the organism actually looks like and acts like. The phenotype is the result of the genotype and the environment interacting. And we can write this in this little formula. The phenotype equals the genotype plus the environment. Imagine if we used an equation where the phenotype was 1, the genotype and the environment, there's different ways you could get this. This could be 0.5 and 0.5. This could be 1 and this could be 0. This could be 0 and this could be 1. There's a lot of different ways to get phenotypes, and it's going to be a combination of genotype and the environment. So to give you an example, eye color is a phenotype, what color your eyes are. And that's going to be due almost entirely to your genotype. So your genes are determining which proteins are being produced and what color they reflect. But there could be an environmental component. Some people's eyes get darker or lighter with their emotions. Or you could pop in some contacts and completely change your phenotype, but your genotype doesn't change. Weight is another example of a trait that's definitely a mix between these two. So how much you weigh is your phenotype, but there's going to be a genetic component of your weight and an environmental component. And it can be hotly debated which has more influence here. Our last definition is gene expression, and this is when a specific gene is actually transcribed and translated into a protein, and the other way we say that is when the gene is turned on. You have to have gene expression in order to have a genotype influence a phenotype. When you see that phenotype, that is gene expression of the genotype. So those are all the key definitions that we need, and now we can jump in and start applying those to the field of genetics.